NASCAR's top drivers talk about the most frightening track they have to face.
Talladega. Talladega. Talladega.
One place that strikes fear into the heart of every NASCAR driver on the circuit.
Talladega. Talladega. Talladega.
Talladega Super Speedway.
Oh, we got a bad crash in the back straightaway.
It's the biggest.
Five lanes wide and banks steeper in the corners than the roof of your house.
Fastest.
Here comes the trouble.
Most dangerous speedway on earth.
We've all been involved in wrecks at Talladega just because of the way the cars are packed so tightly together.
Fasten your seatbelts, because at this track, racers can run, but they can't hide from the big one.
Oh, bam, hard contact.
Gentlemen, start your engine.
It's the Die Hard 500, and 13 drivers are on a dead course for disaster.
Oh, they're in the grass. Oh, here goes Skinner crossing for the body.
Trouble in turn three sends cars spinning and drivers scrambling.
Here they are moving off of corner number two.
And somehow they get in the grass. There we see Jeff Gordon coming directly into him. All of a sudden, Gordon loses control, goes up, bam, hits the wall.
Even Chevy and Rusty Wallace get snake bitten by Talladega.
Well, the chain reaction wrecks are something that you have much control over. You're a victim at that particular point.
That car looks to be a wipeout.
In one split second, 13 drivers end up riding the wrecker instead of heading for the checker.
Here we go, guys.
This time, it's the boys of Bush at the Subway 300.
And we're racing at Talladega.
We're running 190 miles an hour, and we're literally inches, if not touching each other.
Halfway through the race, a restart rattles some nerves and some cages.
Oh, here we go, here we go.
One car at the bottom and two up top.
It's the big one. Oh, there's cars everywhere.
In a replay, you can see a loose tire forces these cars up the track.
Watch the car, watch the car. See that rubber tire roll out from under there, the tread off the tire?
And when racing bumper to bumper, the cars trailing have nowhere to go but into each other.
And everything went haywire from there.
Just look down here in turn one and see who's left.
And look at the litter inside turn four.
In the end, 16 cars pack it up and head for pit road.
In one instance, you can think, man, we're golden, we're gonna get through this. And then in a fraction of a second, that hole can close up and you can be a part of the incident.
He needs to get up front. He's coming through.
And finally, back to Winston Cup for one of the biggest and most memorable tangles in Talladega history.
Oh, no! We have a problem. And the crash that we had hoped would not happen. And look at the mess right here at the start-finish line.
Too numerous to count.
I mean, there's just nowhere to go.
With 52 laps to go, mayhem erupts in front of the grandstand.
Right there is where the trouble's going to start. He makes contact with Robbie Gordon. He goes down, hits, I guess that's the
seven
of Michael Waltrip, and then, look, there's just no place to go.
Driver Michael Waltrip was in the front of the pack, but couldn't escape.
All right, now we go on board with Michael Waltrip.
And we'll just listen this time.
Now that's a scary feeling when you get hit at the front of the pack, because you understand that there's 40 people that are going to come through where you're wrecking at, and you just hope out of those 40, only maybe three or four of them hit you, not all of them.
Talladega strikes again.
And the tire marks tell the story.
Now, folks, I think you understand what we mean by the big one.
Thanks to NASCAR's incredible safety standards, all of these drivers survived the wrath of Talladega. But without a doubt, they came away with a greater respect for the track often called Terradega.